Hello kids, good morning. Today is EVS part 1 period and here is one riddle for you. Before starting a topic, you are going to solve this riddle. Okay, listen carefully. You cannot see it. You cannot touch it. You cannot see it. You cannot touch it. Only you can feel it on your skin. What is it? So, think about this. Now, for more hints, I'm going to show you some video clips that you are going to see carefully and then you will get an answer of this riddle. Okay, so are you ready for it? Watch this.
One man is pumping air into a cycle tube. Two girls are blowing air in a rubber balloon. One man is feeling air in the tire of a car.
So children, what is the answer? Yes, air. Air, we cannot see it, we cannot touch it, but only we can feel it on our skin. Very good. And you had seen that video, those video clips also, and then you got an answer for it, that what is today's topic. So today we are going to start with a new lesson.
Lesson number 9. Air.
Children, in this lesson we are going to do various experiments. Okay, so you all are going to observe it carefully and after this lesson you will also do same at your home but under your parents' guidance. Okay, so watch all the experiments carefully. Let's start with the first experiment.
Take water in a big container or a big bucket. Then take a small narrow container. Now hold it upside down on the surface of the water and without tilting it, push it down into the water. Now allow it to tilt. What do you see? Yes, bubbles rise at once to the top. What does this tell us? Air is lighter than water. So, air bubbles rise to the top as soon as the container is tilted. It means that there was air even in the container that appeared to be empty.
So children, always remember, there is air all around us. It is present even in the places that appear to be empty. Let's start with the next topic.
The atmosphere. The earth on which we live is round in shape like a ball. There is air all around the earth. This covering of air around the earth is called the atmosphere. See children, as we go far away from the earth, the layers of air become thinner. That is, the layers of air closest to the earth are very close to each other, while the ones at higher levels are not so close. The air at greater heights is rare.
So always remember, there is a covering of air all around the earth. That is called as atmosphere. Let's start with the second experiment.
Take a slightly deep dish like a saucer. Stand a candle at its center. Take one glass tumbler and little water. Now, fill water in the dish. After that, light the candle. Now, place a glass tumbler over the candle. What do you see? Soon the candle goes out and the level of water inside the tumbler rises up to a certain level. Now you will think, why does this happen? So, the reason behind this is, one of the constituents of air helps burning. As it gets used up, water rises in the tumbler. But when that constituent is finished, the candle goes out. The water level too stops rising.
Now we shall learn about the different gases present in the air.
The Earth's atmosphere is made of air. The circle in this picture shows all the air in the atmosphere. If we divide the circle into 5 equal parts, then the oxygen in the air will be equal to one of the parts. Apart from oxygen, there are other gases in the atmosphere. Which could those be? The oxygen in the air is used both for burning as well as respiration, that is breathing.
Which are the other uses of air you know about? Let's start with the third experiment.
This is soda water bottle. Now let us see when we open the lid what happens. Bubbles fizz out of it. Children, remember to make soda water, a gas called carbon dioxide is dissolved in water under pressure. When the lid is removed, the pressure reduces and the gas bubbles out. This gas is present in small quantities in air too. You have also learned that plants make their food using air and water in the presence of sunlight. When plants make their food, they use the carbon dioxide from the air. When you place ice in a glass and it becomes very cold, droplets of water settle on its outside. It means that water too is present in air in the form of a gas.
However, the largest part of air is made up of still another kind of gas. This gas is called as nitrogen.
Thus, there are several gases present in air. In other words, air is a mixture of several gases, as you can see in the picture. Do you know the burning that takes place in factories, vehicles, stoves in kitchens, etc. gives out smoke. This smoke too mixes with the air around us and it is very harmful for us. So children, you must always remember, fuels like coal, petrol and diesel gives out smoke while burning, which mixes with the air, and this can cause many ill health. Because it is not good for our health, it is harmful.
So children, hope you all understood the topic. Now let's see what we have learned.
First one, air is present all around us, even in places that appear to be empty. Second one, there is a covering of air all around the earth. It is called the atmosphere. Third one, the layers of air in the atmosphere close to the earth are pressed closer to each other, while the upper layers are rare. Fourth one, air is a mixture of several gases. Oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide and water vapor are its main constituents. Activity for today. Do all three experiments at home with the help of your parents.